Hey, it's Fran, again, in the lab. My lab. With a new friend. This little guy, right here. My little friend. I picked up a bunch of these military surplus Nixie modules from Russia. It's like a six-digit display. Six modules all put together. Got some other single ones for tinkering and discombobulation, because I knew I'd have to tear them apart, reverse engineer them, and come up with a driver. I was pretty confident I could make it work, even though there was no technical data that came with the modules. Pretty interesting too. When I got them open, they were pretty simple. Just a single chip driver board, the Russian equivalent of the SN74141 direct pinout. And I've got a bunch of these in surplus drivers for driving my Nixie tubes, so it's just a matter of following the traces to the pins on the back. And even though these pins are kind of strange rectangular pins, I don't really have a socket that'll work in it, but I do have the pinout figured, so drive it with a regular BCD driver, so can use these for anything. And I got the six-digit module block for a clock, obviously. Interesting thing about these tubes and the chips in them is when they were made. The chips are date-coded 1990, and the tubes and the circuit board are date-coded 1992. And in fact, the labels on the outside of the modules also say 492. Whether that's the fourth week or fourth month, I don't know, but it's kind of interesting because I think it's pretty common acknowledge that the Russians continue to make Nixie tubes as they continue to make all vacuum tubes for surplus. But this isn't just a matter of just producing tubes. These are entire complete modules never used that are still being made in the 90s. And I think after opening it up, part of the explanation of that is that these tubes are not socketed. They're soldered directly to the circuit board, so equipment that these were originally made for, who knows when, in the 60s, 70s, rather than having to take these modules apart, desolder the tube, and put a new tube in, obviously was part of the maintenance for this equipment to just replace the whole module. The board's conformal coated, so you know it's military. Double-sided board, it's got a cap in there, one bypass cap. And the anode loading resistor. These have a 27K anode resistor, so these modules were designed to be run somewhere around neighborhood of 250 volts, which is a little over for the supply that I built for my own benchwork, because I kind of made my own Nixie standard at 175 volts, just because I think it's better to run the lowest possible resistor for your anodes with displays, because if you go crazy bonkers with the voltages, you basically are just asking for trouble, because with the loading and such with the displays, the higher the value resistor, you're just going to be bringing out the inconsistencies in the tubes. So if you have a set of tubes that are not all the same age or not all have like the same brightness, and maybe some of them are a little gassy, the ones that are weaker really show up the more resistance you add to the anode. So I tend to like to drive these kind of displays with the lowest possible resistor, like around 8 or 9 or 10K, and run the voltage down. And so with less resistance when you have it under load, the performance of the Nixie tubes is going to be a little more consistent in a multiple tube display, in my opinion. My power supply standard is 175, so I changed out the resistor in this one, dropped it down to an 8K, which I just sort of made up out of a bunch of quarter watt resistors in a bundle to get basically a 1 watt 8K resistor, just so that I could get it running. But when I do the project with this big brick of modules, I'll take into consideration to build a power supply that's going to run around 250 volts. So I don't have to modify these. I basically just take the pinouts, make my own custom driver for it, and just power it at the voltages intended. So So anyway, that's it for this one. I'll probably do obviously another video about the the clock project when I can get to that. It's gonna be like a little bit down the line because I've got a lot of stuff that I'm in the process of completing right now. I just had to reorganize the lab and sort my projects because I have like 20 or 30 projects that are all sort of in various stages of completion, or parts, you know, almost got together, or research almost completed. And so I've got this huge rack of in-process projects, which will be coming up in the year or years to come. So anyway, that's it for this one. I'm Fran. Thanks for watching. Thanks, too, to all my patrons who make all these videos possible. You're awesome. So if you like my channel, if you like the videos, if you like what I do, consider becoming a patron of the channel. It's easy to do. You just follow the link in the description, become a patron. Even just $1 a month makes a big difference. Anyway, thank you. I'm Fran. I'll see you around the lab real soon. Bye!